you for being here. Thank you for your service to our country. Ambassador, should ambassadors ever try to influence host country elections?
No.
I think you said in your opening statement, partisanship of this type is not compatible with the role of a career foreign service officer. Is that right?
Yeah.
But that's exactly what happened in 2016. In August of 2016, the very month you went to Ukraine as our ambassador, the Ukrainian ambassador here in the United States, Ambassador Chali, wrote an op-ed in The Hill, said this, Trump's comments send wrong message. So the very month you're over there as our ambassador to Ukraine, Ambassador Chali writes that op-ed, and it wasn't just that attack, as Mr. Castor got into earlier, it wasn't just that attack on the president. We had former Ukrainian Prime Minister Yatsenyuk, who criticized candidate Trump. We had Mr. Avakov. I believe earlier you said, Ambassador, that Mr. Avakov was the individual who first alerted you to the efforts of Mr. Giuliani. Mr. Avakov, back during this same time period in the months just prior to the 2016 election, called then-candidate Trump all kinds of names, called him a terrorist. And of course, we have Mr. Lushenko, a member of parliament, who was a source for Fusion GPS and now somewhat famous dossier that flowed from Fusion's work. He said this in the Financial Times, again, in August of 2016, when you first arrived in Ukraine, he said this, the majority of Ukrainian politicians are on Hillary Clinton's side. So you had several high-ranking officials in the government, in the Ukrainian government, and President Poroshenko is president of Ukraine, criticize President Trump, then candidate Trump, all in the late summer and fall of 2016. What I want to know, Ambassador, when this was all happening, did you go talk to anyone in the Ukrainian government about this? Did you go say to some of these officials, hey, you guys need to knock this off. This perception that we got, as Mr. Lushenko said, the majority of Ukrainian politicians on Hillary Clinton's side, that's not good. Did you have that conversation?
No.
Didn't talk to anyone in the government? Did you talk to President Poroshenko?
No.
Didn't alert anyone in the government?
No.
Well, one of the things we've heard so much over the last 6 weeks in depositions, and frankly, in the hearing on Wednesday, is how important bipartisan support is for Ukraine. Democrats and Republicans agree they want to help Ukraine. In fact, the Democrats' first witness, their star witness on Wednesday, Mr. Taylor, said Ukraine's most important strategic asset is this bipartisan support. And you would agree with that, right?
I do.
He said this in his testimony on Wednesday. On September 11th, I learned that the hold had been lifted the next day. Ambassador Taylor said, I conveyed this news to President Zelensky and the Ukrainian foreign minister, and I reminded Mr. Yarmak of the high strategic value of bipartisan support for Ukraine and the importance of not getting involved in other countries' elections. So what I'm wondering is, this is the day after the aid's been lifted that Ambassador Taylor made this statement to the Ukrainian government. And he makes this after there's nothing been done by Ukraine to influence our election. Because President Zelensky didn't announce he was doing an investigation and the aid was lifted. But he felt he needed to say that. But in 2016, when we know that the majority of Ukrainian politicians want Clinton to win, because it was said by a member of parliament, when the ambassador to the United States from Ukraine writes an op-ed criticizing then-candidate Trump, when Mr. Avakov calls candidate Trump all kinds of names, nobody goes and talks to him and tells him to knock it off. Did you have any conversations, Ambassador, with Victoria Nuland or Secretary of State Perry about what was going on in 2016 and this majority of Ukrainian politicians being for candidate Clinton and not and opposed to President Trump?
No, I did not.
No one did anything. No one did anything. You see why maybe the president was a little concerned about what went on in Ukraine? And you couple that with the corruption level that we know exists in Ukraine, you add to that this idea that he's not a big fan of foreign aid, why he might be a little concerned about sending the hard-earned tax dollars of the American people to Ukraine?
I'm sorry, is there a question there?
There was.
Okay, could you repeat it, please?
I'm asking...
Time of the gentleman has expired, but I'll allow you to repeat the question.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'm asking, maybe we can kind of see why the president was a little concerned when you have the highest-ranking officials in the government, the ambassador criticizing him, parliamentary member Lashenko criticizing him, when you have Avakov, the guy who first told you about Giuliani, criticizing him. All this going on, and when you couple that with the concerns he has about corruption, the concerns he has about Europe not doing enough, the concerns he has about reluctance to send in the hard-earned tax dollars to any country,
Jordan,
frankly.
I have indulged you with extra time, but
I appreciate it.
My indulgence is wearing out.
I appreciate it.
There is a question, right?
Our indulgence wore out with you a long time ago, Mr. Chairman.
Well,
I'll tell you that.
I'm about to gavel you down, so if you have a question, I suggest you...
I'm asking her, do you think there's maybe a reason that this was, that President Trump's concern was justified?
You know, I can't speak for the president on this, but what I would say is you've listed a number of actions. I think from my point of view, that doesn't create a Ukrainian government strategy to interfere in our election.
I didn't say that.
Mr. Jordan, please allow the ambassador to answer the question.
So I would just say that, you know, U.S. politicians will often criticize policies of foreign counterparts, even perhaps during their elections. You know, this happens in politics, and I think that it doesn't necessarily constitute interference.
Would you ever write an op-ed
Jordan, your time
critical of a presidential candidate in Ukraine?
Jordan.